welcome to this fourth lecture on architecture patterns. This lecture is on the role of reference architectures in architecture design. We've been through the architecture design process a couple of times, and now we will focus on reference architectures that play an important role in often in larger projects where you have large complex applications that are extremely difficult to comprehend, and a reference architecture will provide a head start for a development team. So we've been through the three types of architecture knowledge that we consider in this class: patterns and tactics, and now the focus is on a reference architecture. Reference architecture is maybe not that widely known, widely used, and I believe that the main reason for that is that its focus on really complex applications, and you don't often see or use these complex systems in educational settings, and that's probably the reason why the reference architecture role has been played down a bit. And I think that they have become more used recently due to certain developments in the IT market, where you have more even a small developer can utilize complex systems for instance to put applications in the cloud, use the cloud for storage or for complex computations, etc. But in order to use these cloud infrastructures, you have to understand quite a lot to make the best out of the resources they provide. So one example here is okay, we have a development team here, and they don't really know where to start. They have a client who asked them to build some IoT system that uses Amazon infrastructure for IoT, but well, where should they start? They don't really know that. They don't really know what's needed. Are there any guiding principles, patterns, etc.? And this is a perfect case to illustrate when a reference architecture is useful. The Department of Defense in the United States, they define a reference architecture as an authoritative source of information. So it is a source of information that is describing, well, truth is a strong word, but an absolute fact about how to structure, how to organize, what to include in a certain type of system. A specific subject area is interesting here, because as you will see, a subject area can be cut in two different ways, but the authoritative source here can be used to guide architects, can also constrain the architectures that these architects design. But what's important here is that the reference architecture is an abstraction that is valid for multiple architectures, or, well, multiple implementations. So a reference architecture is a specific solution template for a domain. It typically provides a number of responsibility structures. It highlights patterns, it highlights tactics used in this reference architecture. In this picture, you have a reference architecture for RESTful applications, and you can expand the reference architecture, zoom in a bit, and you can see that there is an API gateway, there are RESTful APIs, etc., etc. So the idea here with the reference architecture is that anyone who would like to build an application like this, well, they can go in here and use this cookbook to identify the ingredients needed, how to combine the ingredients, and at the end of the day, mix the ingredients' behavior into a fully functional application. The only thing that it's not covered here by the reference architecture is, of course, the core functionality of the application you're expected to build. So domain-specific solution is interesting because you can consider two types of reference architectures where you cut the domain either horizontally or vertically. And an example of a vertical reference architecture is the AutoSAR, Automotive Open System Architecture, on the left-hand side. This is a reference architecture that also comes with reference implementations. So you can, as a provider of hardware or software or both, or platforms for automotive industry, you can use AutoSAR as a point of reference to guide your own design, of course, but you can also use it to back-to-back test your software. Does it work or not? Can I plug this piece in or can I not? And this is one example of a vertical domain dependent. And you will find similar domain dependent reference architectures in the medical domain, in the defense domain, in banking, fintech, in web app, etc. So vertical reference architectures are around everywhere, and they are extremely useful in many different settings. The other horizontal is slightly more domain independent, or at least it's cut, the domain is cut slightly different. So we can, for instance, consider the web application reference architecture that we looked at the previous slide. You can use this reference architecture to build a variety of systems in various domains, but this is more the implementation architecture that this reference architecture addresses. So reference architectures are extremely useful for the development teams that faces a complex domain, a complex setting, a domain where they have not been before, where they have not seen too many implementations, where the existing systems are difficult to study because they're is maybe no systems in the open source. They are also useful for domains where standardization is important, for instance, in the automotive industry. So, for instance, this team here that are looking for the IoT aspects in Amazon infrastructure, they can find lots of information from the infrastructure provider where they should start, what they need, and also lots of documentation about guiding principles and patterns. So for instance, you have this picture here to put IoT in context for Amazon. They have that AWS IoT, which contains a number of sensors and actuators on the left-hand side, the green icons there. They are dealt with by this IoT composite where you can harvest data from the sensors. You can put them in a queue, and then you have various elements from Amazon that takes care of these queues and forwards data to be stored in a database. And then at the right-hand side, at the end of this stream, you have different IoT applications and dashboards. So now imagine that you're a team member Just by looking at this diagram, you will get a basic understanding of, well, how things work, which things are included in this setup, and you can continue and look further into the various elements in this diagram, and you can look at the AWS IoT here, AWS here, IoT, and you can see that there are various gateways. There is support for authentication, authorization. There is a registry. There is an API that you can use to program this. And then there are the connections to applications or other AWS services. So the team can continue to process information, to use this infrastructure as the backbone in their applications that their customer wants them to build. So with the reference architecture, the team understand the context. They understand what's needed by AWS, and to some extent they also need to understand the guiding principles and the patterns. So now they need to fill in the blanks here, and that is the core functionality of the application they are supposed to build. So the role of reference architecture in architecture design is for the architects to get a head start to jumpstart the process, especially when they enter a domain where they have not been before, where they have not seen too many systems, the experience is low or none. And a reference architecture, useful, often open, standardized, and it provides a lot of information for the architects when they start to address a complex architecture. So that was the fourth and final lecture in this theme, and now it's time to move on to the next theme, which will focus on architecture tactics.